Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the mantle or pallial cavity. In the previous video we have studied about the mantle or pallium, which is a membrane that covers the visceral mass, and that membranes form the mantle cavity. Now this diagram represents the organs in the mantle cavity of female Pila. Here we can see there are various organs present in the body of the Pila. So except the foot and the mouth, we can consider all these regions, all these organs that are present in the mantle cavity. Before studying the each and every organ that is present in the mantle cavity, we need to clear about the two terms, which is floor and the roof. So roof and floor, these are the two positions where the organs of the mantle cavity are present. Jo roof hai, yani ki chhat, which constitute most of the organs of the Pila. And they are formed by the anterior free part of the mantle. यानी कि जो आगे वाला part है body के, जो anterior part है, which is the front part of the body, this represents the roof of the mantle, roof of the roof position, जहाँ पे बाकी roof के organs present है. And most of the organs जो है वो roof में ही present होते हैं. The next thing is the floor. Floor के जो organs हैं, they are present on the dorsal surface of the body behind the head. अब जो ये जो head present है diagram में, इस head के पीछे, यानी कि dorsal side, यानी कि अपने head के पीछे वाले parts में जो है floor, this represents the floor of the mantle cavity. और यहाँ पे जो है बाकी organs present हैं. Floor के जो organs हैं वो कम हैं, मतलब कि the remaining organs are present on the floor, while the most of the organs are present on the roof. So roof and floor both together constitute the mantle cavity, organs of the mantle cavity. So roof and floor में जो हैं organs present हैं mantle cavity के. And here we can see various organs. So all these organs which are present in the mantle cavity, they are collectively known as organs of the pallial complex. So the pallial complex are the organs that are present in the mantle cavity. Now ये जो mantle cavity है, इसके अंदर roof and floor की positions हैं, और जो various organs present हैं, वो हैं epithenium, pulmonary sac which is also known as lung, oscillatorium, tenadium or gill, rectum, genital duct, kidney. So first of all, let's study about the epithenia. तो यहाँ पे we can see in the diagram this yellow region represents the epithenia. तो ये जो body का ये जो yellow region है, this represents the epithenia. And epithenia is a prominent ridge, एक उभरी हुई जो ridge है, यानी कि उभरा हुआ एक ऐसा structure है जो कि बहुत ही prominent है, बहुत ही निकला हुआ है. So it forms the it is basically a prominent ridge which divides the mantle cavity into two unequal regions. तो ये जो mantle cavity है, इसको दो unequal regions में divide करता है. जैसे कि first of all यहाँ पे we can see here is the pulmonary chamber and here is the branchial chamber. On the right side of the epithenia is the branchial chamber and on the left side is the pulmonary chamber. So pulmonary chamber और branchial chamber में epithenia एक ऐसी prominent ridge है which divides the mantle cavity into two unequal region. The left larger pulmonary chamber, we can see the left larger pulmonary chamber, the left larger pulmonary chamber and the right smaller branchial chamber. So दो chambers में epithenia जो है mantle cavity को divide कर देता है. So this is about the epithenia. और ये जो है posterior, ये जो है extend करता है comes to the floor. यहाँ पे floor की तरफ आ रहा है because head के पीछे जो है this region जो है this region is behind the head. तो dorsal surface of the head में है. So this represents the floor and this represents the roof of the mantle cavity, right? तो यहाँ पे जो है floor तक आ रहा है from the to the posterior end of the cavity. So this is the anterior end of the cavity. This is the posterior end of the cavity. So anterior से posterior position तक आ रहा है, right? So this is about the epithenia. And the next one is the pulmonary sac or lung. So यहाँ पे pulmonary sac or lung is a large bag which is hanging from the roof of the pulmonary chamber. Now we know that roof जो है which portion it is. So the pulmonary sac is a large bag which is hanging from the roof of the pulmonary chamber and opening into a large aperture called pulmonary aperture or pneumostome. This we can get to know from the diagram. यहाँ पे this this structure represents the pulmonary sac. So the pulmonary sac is a large structure which is hanging from the roof of the pulmonary chamber. So this is pulmonary chamber ki roof se, yani ki is upar wale portion se ek sac like structure, ek thaile jaisa structure present hai jisko pulmonary sac ya lung keh sakte hain. And this lung opens into the pulmonary chamber. Ye iske saath connected hai with the help of pulmonary aperture or you can say pneumostome. So pulmonary aperture or pneumostome is a way by which the pulmonary sac connects with the pulmonary chamber and it is present on the roof. Right, now the next structure is osphaeridium. So osphaeridium is a very small oval leaf like structure which is attached to the roof of the pulmonary chamber just behind the base of left neutral lobe. This we can also get to know from the diagram. So here if we see this structure, this is present on the left side of the body. So this is the osphaeridium. Abhi jo osphaeridium hai, it's a leaf like structure which is present on the roof of pulmonary chamber. So pulmonary chamber ka, I have already told you that this region represents the roof. So it is present at the roof of the pulmonary chamber just behind the left neutral lobe. So this left neutral lobe hai, iske piche present hai. This is the osphaeridium leaf like structure which is only present on the left side of the body. So here you can see this is the osphaeridium. Now the next organ which is present in the mantle cavity is tenadium or a gill. So tenadium ya jo gill hai, it's a very long lamellar organ hanging from the mantle. So ye bhi mantle se hang kar raha at the extreme right side of the branchial chamber. So here this is the diagram. This structure represents the tenadium or gill. So ye jo gill hai, this is first of all is present very right to the branchial chamber. Ye jo branchial chamber hai, pulmonary chamber is on the left side and the branchial chamber is on the right side. So branchial chamber ki side mein jo hai, sabse last mein jo hai, it's a lamellar organ because the gills are formed of the lamella. So ye ek lamellar organ hai jo ki which hangs from the mantle cavity and it extends to the floor, up to the floor of the body. So yahan tak jo hai ye gill or tenadium jo hai present hai. We know that the gill helps in the respiration. Now the next thing is that is about the rectum. So rectum is a tube which is situated on the left side of the gill on the floor of the branchial chamber and it opens into the mantle cavity or we can say branchial chamber because we know that mantle cavity is divided into pulmonary chamber and the branchial chamber by anus just behind the right neutral lobe. So yahan pe we can also get to know about the rectum from the diagram. So here is the diagram. This tube represents the rectum. So ye jo rectum hai, that is also present at the floor of the mantle cavity. It is present at the left side of the tenadium and from the branchial chamber it is at the right position. It opens into anus. Jo rectum hai, that opens into anus and just behind the right neutral lobe. So here is the right neutral lobe. Right neutral lobe ke thode se piche ya uske thode se piche anus se open hota hai. Rectum opens into anus just behind the right neutral lobe. So this is about the rectum. The next thing is the next organ is the vagina or we can say vas deferens in case of male. So the genital ducts, that they lie on the left of the rectum. So rectum se left side pe present hai with its aperture a little behind the anus. So vagina or vas deferens, which is collectively we can say genital duct. So male and female ke jo genital duct hai, they lie on the left side of the rectum. So here this is the rectum. So rectum ke left side pe, yani ki rectum ke left side pe, this represents the vagina and this vagina that opens before it opens into anus. Anus ke thode se piche ek tube hai. This is the opening of the vagina. So this is the reproductive structure of the female pila which is present on the left side of the rectum. So we can, this is all clear from the diagram that at which side, at which position the all the organs are present of the mantle cavity. The next is about the kidneys. So the anterior chamber of the kidney, because the kidney is divided into anterior and posterior chamber, it's a reddish mass projecting into the branchial chamber. Agar aap kabhi bhi pila ki dissection karoge, so you will see a reddish sac like structure. This represents the kidney of the pila and it is present near the posterior end of epithelia, and it opens into a small slit like renal aperture. So यहाँ पे जो किडनी है, यहाँ पे वी कैन सी दिस स्ट्रक्चर रिप्रेजेंट्स द किडनी. सो किडनी इज प्रेजेंट, दिस इज द पोजिशन ऑफ द किडनी एंड इट इज प्रेजेंट एट द पोस्टीरियर एंड ऑफ एपिटेनिया. दिस इज द पोस्टीरियर एंड ऑफ एपिटेनिया, दिस इज द एंटीरियर एंड ऑफ एपिटेनिया. सो किडनी इज अ रेडिश सैक, लाल रंग की थैले की तरह एक ऑर्गन है जो कि एंटीरियर चैम्बर जो है यहाँ पे हमें दिखेगा एंड इट इज प्रेजेंट एट द पोस्टीरियर एंड ऑफ द एपिटेनिया. सो दिस इज जस्ट द इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गन्स. ये अलग अलग ऑर्गन्स जो है इनके सिर्फ इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट है. वी विल गेट टू नो मोर अबाउट देम इफ वी स्टडी अबाउट देयर फर्दर अबाउट देयर सिस्टम्स लाइक अबाउट डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, अबाउट द एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम, नर्वस सिस्टम, रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. सो इन ऑल दैट वी गेट टू नो अबाउट दीज ऑर्गन्स लाइक मोर प्रिसाइजली. द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट वी नो दैट this is the female pila, and in case of male pila there is a structure, the genital duct, the copulatory organs which is present in the mantle cavity. They include the penis and the hypobranchial glands. So they both arises from the edge of the mantle cavity and they get connected with the genital duct only during copulation. So the penis and a hypobranchial gland arises from the edge of the mantle की एज से arise होते हैं and they get connected with the genital duct. जो genital duct है उसके साथ ये connect होते हैं only during copulation. So copulation के time पे ये connect हो जाते हैं and the hypobranchial glands lie on the base of the penis. So जो hypobranchial glands है they lie on the base of the penis of the male pila. So this is about the body, or we can say mantle cavity of the pila, in which we have studied about the various organs that are present in the mantle cavity. You also got to know about what is the floor and the base of that mantle cavity. They both collectively form that mantle cavity and all these organs that they are present in them. So this diagram is very important in order to know about the mantle or pallial cavity, and we can easily understand the positions and the formation and the, you know, and on which sides and on which side it is present. So this is all clear from the diagram. So I hope that you like this video, and if you did, then please don't forget to subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.